Mechanical engineers solve problems. If something is supposed to move, or if it's supposed to not move, a mechanical engineer probably had a hand in designing it. Mechanical engineers design everything from new types of rockets to new types of automobiles to buildings to batteries, really anything in our built environment. Mechanical engineering is about how do we realize and solve problems with the materials that are available to us. The ability to realize new types of materials changes the kinds of problems we can solve. And so materials engineering, materials discovery, very broadly, allows us to solve new types of problems. Traditionally, mechanical design in large spaces necessarily is a digital process. If we want to test a lot of different designs to see which one's best, the only efficient way to do it is to use a computer. And that's because the experiments are slow and the experiments are manual. And so our approach to combining 3D printing and mechanical testing allows us to do in the physical space what was previously only accessible in a digital space. And that's important because not everything can be simulated. And the properties we're looking at, things like how much energy is absorbed in this kind of impact scenario, these are things that we do not have great predictors for in simulation. And so as a result, this is the only real way to do this kind of optimization, to learn. So it gives us access to new types of properties, things we couldn't design for before efficiently. AI is transforming every piece of the mechanical engineering field, from how we analyze data to how we think about and amalgamate that data to how we generate new models and generate new ideas. It's become a tool that's both used for analysis and writing emails these days. And so it's really in every piece of our field. There are four main benefits to an automated lab. One is that you simply get more data. And that's very useful because a lot of when we train models, when we try to answer complicated problems, we need a lot of data. The second is because the experiments are performed by a robot, they're intrinsically more repeatable than if different people were performing them in slightly different ways. As a third thing, the experiments are chosen by machine learning algorithms that can think in high dimensional spaces much more efficiently than humans can. So therefore, the experiments are chosen in a much better way. And then finally, in a manual experiment, there's a step where a person needs to go and write down and record all the little pieces of information that are relevant. In an automated lab, that all happens automatically. So the data, when it's produced, is already tagged with all the relevant information that can make you make connections you might otherwise not make. A lot of the things we care about really fall into simple experiments, but then moreover, maybe they can be predicted from simple experiments. And that's one mental paradigm shift that people are making in the autonomous lab community, is how do we take a proxy or surrogate measurement, something that we can measure easily, and use that to predict more complicated responses. Then we can do the experiment, maybe manually if we need to. The point being that we have a large library of comparable data that's useful for us in our design process. When I evaluate data that either came from a manual experimentation or an automated or autonomous experimentation, it's usually the case that in the autonomous experimentation, there's more time spent debugging the experiment and more controls presented about that experiment. And so that makes the data more trustworthy in the sense that we know the limits of it. And also we know that there's a certain degree of consistency that can be quantified in terms of the automated process. So those certainly make me feel like that data is more trustworthy. Automated labs are complicated. They involve both a domain piece. For example, in mechanical engineering, you have a mechanics piece, but they also involve robotics, software, machine vision. And these are typically things that require different expertise, different types of people to address. And so both the mechanical and the computational side of an automated lab are complicated and present different types of challenges. Programming and a lot of the tools that can be used are open and available open source code, which in many ways makes them easy to use, although there's still challenges in adapting them. In the mechanical side, then the challenge is how do you take an experiment that was traditionally done by a person and maybe has a lot of small tweaks that are done and have that be done in an automated and reliable fashion with a robot? One example being, if you 3D print something and you want to test it, you need to take that from the 3D printer and test it. If you've ever removed something from a 3D printer, fused filament fabrication, you know that it can be adhered strongly to the bed. So that's a simple thing for a human. You just apply enough force. It's much more complicated for a robot. So there's a lot of integrated challenges that come up when you try to, say, solve problems that are traditionally done manually instead with a robot.